So I wanted to talk a little bit today about how to build that confidence, right? Even when you don't have it, how to gain it, how to build it. So it's like a kick-ass level of confidence that you start to build within yourself, even when no one else believes in you. Because I've been through plenty of those days where nobody else gave a crap about me. Nobody else believed in me or what I was capable of. And I just had to find it within myself. And what I started to realize, because I'd seen it, not only in myself going through it, but I'd seen it in working with clients that I trained with their lack of belief in themselves. And I was always trying to get them to believe, because I knew if they could believe in themselves, that was the key to overcoming a lot of the pain and injuries they had. It wasn't the physical limitations, right? So it's the same thing here when you're going after things. And the problem is that we set goals for ourselves, and it's like we're standing on one side of the cliff, like this big cliff, and on the other side there's this other cliff or this other side to the mountain that we want to get across, and it's as big as the Grand Canyon. And the problem is that we're trying to take a jump from where we're at all the way across the Grand Canyon to the other side. And then, of course, we don't have the strength or the power to jump that far, so we fall short. And then what we do when we fall short is we label our dreams as impossible, and we think that we're failures. And that's the big problem, because it really knocks our confidence down. We start believing that it's impossible to be, have, and do what we want in life. Our goals aren't achievable. Other people might be able to do them, but not us. And the trick to it all is to stop trying to jump from where you are to where you want to be in one shot, right? You can't get there in one shot. You don't have to, because there's no such thing as overnight successes. With all these celebrities and athletes and movie stars and all these people who are labeled overnight successes, they don't get there overnight like it seems. See, what they're not showing you is all of the days and the months and the years, all of the failures they went through to get where they are. All the times they tried and came up short. All the times people told them they were nuts, they were crazy, their goals were never going to happen, and messed with their confidence. But you don't see all of the work they did when nobody else knew who they were, when nobody else was watching. See, that's the stuff we've got to do. And it's not about jumping from where you are to where you want to be in one shot. What it is, it's knowing where you want to go and then chopping it down into smaller goals to where all you're trying to do is take one step to the other side. It's like building yourself a bridge across to the other side. And all you do is you build that bridge one piece of wood at a time. You lay one piece down and you take that first step. Then when you take that step, build the next one and take another step. And then build the next one. That's all you need to do. It's just getting yourself one step closer. So why this is important in building confidence and how it works is because when you set smaller goals, they're not as overwhelming for you, right? They're a little bit easier and more manageable, and mentally they're a lot easier to take on. And when you achieve these small goals, by themselves, a small goal it doesn't seem like much, but when you stack one on top of the other, on top of the other, on top of the other, and you're moving your way across that bridge of life toward your destination where you want to go, and then you look back and you see how far you've come, and that's when it hits you. You realize how far you've come during this whole journey. And what it does is those small little successes that you achieve on a daily basis, little by little by little, they start building little bits of confidence. See, every time you achieve a small success, it builds a little confidence, like a bank account. And the more deposits you make into your confidence account, the bigger your confidence becomes. And before you know it, what you'll start doing is setting bigger goals for yourself. If I did this, then maybe I could do that. And it's a self-reinforcing cycle, because then the goals that you achieve, they give you the confidence to set bigger goals. And then you set those bigger goals, and then it makes you want to set even bigger ones. And then you keep gaining more confidence, and it's a snowball effect. Self-reinforcing cycle. So that's about it. Don't worry about getting from where you are now to where you want to go in one big giant jump. Don't label yourself a failure. Don't label your dreams as impossible. Just take one small step at a time, and before you know it, you'll be to the other side.